Hi, hope you guys are doing well. So we're at I think part 7 of our beginner Metroverse thing. In this part we will be, I think this is the second last part, and in this part we will be creating a sign, two signs actually, over here, and also we're going to be animating the water and the smoke of the volcano. So let's get started. First of all, I'm just going to hide everything that we don't need, and so first we'll create the sign, bigger sign, shift a mesh cylinder and make the subdivisions 8 because it is low poly anyway. So scale it and then SZ to scale it longer and then G to move it about over here. This looks good enough, and then it's pretty outside of our station, but for now it's okay. And then shift A, mesh Q, scale it to make it bigger, and then SZ to scale it on the Z axis and SX to scale it on the x-axis to make it less thick on the sides. GZ to move it above, and then GY to move it on the side. Click on the cylinder and copy its y-axis because we are at the y-axis right now. Okay, so copy its y-axis, it's going to be different for you. Copy and then paste it on the sign over here. We're just going to rename it as sign. And the cylinder we can name it as sign pole. Click on the sign, tab into edit mode, go into edge select mode, and click on shift and click on the side edges. Okay, as you can see, okay, this is just four side edges, and then click on control V to bevel them, and then scroll the mouse wheel to add in a few extra subdivisions. Then go to first select mode and select the first front face, and then shift select the back face, and then click on I to insert, and then scale it on the inside about this much. Then we're going to select and invert it. Okay, by selecting and inverting, by using select invert command, the things that will be selected will be deselected, and the things that aren't selected will be selected. Okay, so select, invert, now everything else but the front face is selected. Now one to side view, and then Z wireframe, and then B to box select, and then click on shift and deselect these side faces. Okay, and then we'll come back to solid mode, and only these faces should be selected. Okay, now create two materials, or create one material new. We'll just call it text. We're going to be adding text later on, so that's why I'm calling it text, and make it a purplish sort of color. Then click on the plus sign, and then the same material as the prong materials, we're also going to be using it. Okay, so click on the prong one, and then Z material view. Now you can see that by default it's already given the text material to all of it. So now click on select and invert. Now everything else but these those faces are selected, and by selecting the prong material, click on assign. So now it's looking like this. Okay, this is what we want it to look like. So shift and select both this sign and sign pole and move it into the station collection. And now we're going to be creating another sign over here. This is right now we're just going to creating the text. Okay, so shift A, text, click on it, and now the text is sort of different, material than the usual one. It's basically curves. Okay, when you click on tab to go to edit mode, we actually get this typer instead of the usual edges, vertices, etc. So if you want to, but we're not going to be doing it for this tutorial, but if you want to, you convert it into an actual mesh. Click on object, convert to mesh from curve, text, metadata, etc. But we don't need that for this this tutorial, and you can see that we have a menu here for the text itself. So first of all, I'm going to tab into edit mode, and we're going to be naming the bus service. So I'll name it Narwhal, and enter to go downward express. Narwhal Express, this is the name of the bus service. Then we're going to be creating another sign pole for the station itself. So there are a lot of settings over here, like you can change the font, geometry, etc. A lot of settings they can be changed, but we're not going to be looking at all of them. We're just going to align them into the center. Okay, and in the geometry, I'm just going to extrude it by 0.3. I think this is good enough for now. So, and also I'm just going to give it the material of the text. This is why naming is important. Okay, so let's just go into the side view and rx 90 to move it like this, rz 90 to move it this side, and gy to move it on this side, gz to move it above, and then scale it. Went to side view, I think this is it, and then gx to move it so that we can actually see it outside of it. Okay, let me just go into material preview. We're going to scale it again. Gz to move it a little bit above. I think this looks good. So because this is not a regular mesh and I haven't converted it, because there will be too many subdivisions, so we can't control J and join it with this sign over here. So we're going to be parenting it. So click on this text and then shift click on the sign, and then click on control J. Oh, then click on control P and to parent to object. Okay, so now they're parented and they're also separated as well. So click on the sign and rotate it, and you can see that it's also moving along with the text is also moving along with it. So now we're going to be creating the name of this station sign over here. So let's just keep it simple. Shift A, mesh, cube, scale it to move it, make it a bit bigger, G, Z to move it above, and then G, Y to move it on this side, and then G, Z to move it above again. Okay, and then S and Y to make it thinner on the Y axis, and then S, Z to make it smaller on the x-axis, and then shift D, G, Z to move it downwards, and add in a meter modifier to the second cube. Okay, and then tab into edit mode on the second cube. Okay, and then S, X to make it about this thinner, and then S, Y to make it thinner again, and make sure clipping is turned off. So I'm going to make it mirror on the y-axis instead of x. In my case, I get around it, it's going to be on your case. So G and X and move it on the side. Oh, it's what's supposed to be X, not Y. So now we have the sign pole ready, and then apply the mirror form modifier, and then shift click this upper cube, and then click on control J, and now they're the same object. So we're just going to be calling it sign 2. And now we also need to add a text for it as well. I think the sign is above, so move it downward. We also need to create text for this one, so we'll just duplicate this text. So shift D, G, Z to move it downward. Now the problem is that because this text was printed to the sign, this duplicate is also printed to the sign. You can see this dotted line, so we need to remove the parent. So while selecting this text, click on object, parent, clear parent. So now it's independent of this second text. So RZ 90 again to move it on this side, GY to move it over here, click on this sign, and because we're on the I think x-axis, so copy it's x-axis 0, so now click on this text and make it x also 0, GZ to move it downwards, and GZ to move it downward, then click on tab to go into edit mode. This is why I didn't turn it into a mesh late, because I wanted to cycle it. So we're just going to call it volcano view .st station, tab out, and then scale it to make it fit the sign, GY to move it on the front, GY to move it a little bit of back. And this looks good now. Also, this sign, give it the same material as again the prongs, and the volcano views. Remove the text material from here and click on new, and give it a new material called text 2. And we're just going to be giving it a different color for now. Like I said, we're going to be creating the materials in detail later on. So now that that's done, I'll just make everything reappear. Okay, so the next thing we're going to be creating is emitting is the ocean. So we don't need the station and road lights, etc. We're just going to be animating the ocean. So for this, click on the environment one, click on shift A, and select empty. You can select any one of these except for the image. So I'm just going with plane axis and click over here, and then move GZ to move it above. Now an empty is an object that isn't rendered but can do a lot more things. Basically, when we rendered out the image, it won't be present over there, but can control a lot of the other things going on around the scene. So click selected ocean. Hopefully you hadn't applied the displacement modifier. So in the displacement modifier, change the local into object, and this empty is called as, let me check, it's called empty 001. So in the displacement modifier in the object panel, you can select empty 001, or you can use this dropper tool, this dropper over here, to select the empty 001. Okay, so I have selected it, and I think the empty is sort of small, so that's why our ocean is turning spiky like this. Select the empty and then scale it to make it bigger. As you can see, the ocean is still being affected by it. So we're going to be keep making it the ocean, the empty bigger. And I think, let me just select this ocean and check one thing. I think we didn't add a subdivision surface modifier. So add modifier, add in a subdivision surface modifier above it, and make it just one strength. Okay, so now the ocean automatically looks a lot more smoother. So we're going to be now, as you can see, whenever I move the empty, the ocean seems to move along with it. So we're going to be animating the empty, which in turn will animate the ocean itself. So on frame one, go to frame one, okay, like this, and the end frame should be 240. Okay, because the FPS for this one, frames per second, is 24. That means 24 frames in 1 second are present. Okay, so 24 images will be created for 1 second. So if there are 240 frames, that means it's going to be a 10 second animation. So on frame one, while sliding the empty selected, go into its settings. Okay, so we're just going to be rotating it around, because I did that in my original animation. So we're going to be choosing keyframes. Keyframes basically locks the position of the frame. Okay, you need at least 2 keyframes to make things work. So we're going to be adding 1 keyframe on frame one, and then we're going to be adding another keyframe on frame 240, and the rest in the in between frames will be created by Blender itself. So it's really useful, and keyframes can be used for location, rotation, scaling. They can also be used for changing the colors of the world or objects, etc. There are a lot of applications of the keyframes. So let's just get started. So on frame one, while having the empty selected, go on to the rotation panel and make sure that your mouse is on this part over here, and then click on I to add a keyframe. Now it's yellow in color, that's how you know that a keyframe has been added. Now move it to frame 240. Okay, frame 240, and now change all of these values. So I'm just going to go with 360 because that's what I did originally in the preview. Now it's orange in color, that's signifying that there is no keyframe added. So again, while having your mouse over on it, click on I to add another keyframe. These yellow dots also represent the 2 keyframes we added. So now when I hit play, you can see that the ocean is moving around. Okay, so now the ocean has been animated. We're also going to be now we also need to add the smoke for the volcano. So and now this part is sort of important, because basically when I'm going to rotate in whichever mode, it really matters. Basically, if I rotate something in object mode, you're supposed to rotate it to object mode, and if I rotate something in edit mode, you have to rotate it in the edit mode, okay, or else it will be giving you different results. So let's get started. First of all, shift A, mesh, cylinder. Okay, and now for this one, I'll just hide this guy because it will get in our way, and then I'm just going to scale the cylinder about this much that it can fit in the volcano, and then S that to make it move. So okay, and then tab to go into edit mode, and then click on Control R, and then start scrolling your mouse wheel to add in these loop cuts. I think this much is good for now, and then tab out, then go to the modifiers tab. Okay, while you're out of the object mode, remember the mode, object mode or edit mode really matters for this part. Add modifier. Okay, and then add in a wave modifier. So right, as you can see now, it's actually moving a bit like this, but we don't want it. And also let me just show you better if you know that, and then add in a subdivision surface modifier, give it a strength of 1 for now again, and then tap to go into edit mode, deselect everything and select everything, and then go and click RX90, and then tap to come out of edit mode. And you can see that when you play it, the bounciness of these the weird waves start when we actually start forming later on, but we want them to be formed like at this part there also is only one wave, and then we move it forward, and then there are multiple waves. We wanted to be multiple waves from the start, so that's why we're in the wave modifier, change the offset to -100, I guess. This way the waves are already been created. Also, I don't know why the subdivision surface modifier isn't working. So from I think 2 is better, because that's working better. So now that we have these waves, click on RX90 while you're outside of edit mode. Okay, so now tab to come into edit mode, Z wireframe, deselect everything, B to box select just the top face or top edges over here, I think top vertices over here, and then click on O to turn on proportional editing, and then scale it, and you know, make the region a little bit smaller about over here, and make it like this, and then tap to come out of edit mode, and you can see a smoke has been created like this. So this is the sort of end result we wanted, but this is way too wavy for my taste. But if you want to create it for differently like this for yourself, that's fine with me. Change the height. I'll change the height to 0.3 or maybe 0.2 to make it less moving. So when I play it, you can see that the smoke is also moving. Now its speed is also way too high for my taste. I think 0.1 is better. So you can see the smoke is moving now slowly. So also create a new material for the smoke. New, name it smoke. Like I said so many times in this tutorial, we're going to be creating the materials all together later on. So now that the smoke has been created, G is there to move it above like this, and then GX to move it about here inside the volcano. I think this looks good enough. So now let me just bring out everything back for now. I think I animated almost everything that we had to. Oh, I think I forgot to animate the sign. So click on the sign, go into its properties, okay, and on frame 1, go to its rotation and then hover your mouse on it and click on I to add a keyframe. Then go to frame 240 and then change the Z axis to 360. Okay, so basically stripping all the way around, and then click on I again to add in a second keyframe. So let's just see now. Yes, the sign is also slowly rotating. The ocean is rotating, and also the smoke is also moving around. So in the next part, we'll be properly creating the materials and rendering it out. Maybe the next part is the last, I don't exactly know. So please subscribe to our channel, leave a like, and see you next time. Goodbye.